Hello laser enthusiast, I'm Quentin from Mekanika. Today I will show you the basic features and functionalities on Lightburn. In this tutorial, you will learn how to do your first engraving and cutting using a laser cutter. Lightburn is a user-friendly software designed for laser cutting and engraving. It is suitable for hobbyists and professionals alike. First of all, we will start by importing a device profile parameter into Lightburn. This allows you to import your machine's characteristics in the software. Go to the Device tab and import a device profile. In my case, I am adding a Mekanika Pro model size S. You can find all our machine's profiles on our website and the link is in the description. If you are using a LED laser for a CNC like me, it can be useful to go to the preferences and change the units used from millimeter per second to millimeter per minute, as it is a more common unit for CNC machines. Lightburn interface is split in two main parts, the design interface and the parameters interface. We will start with the design and then assign the parameters. For this tutorial, we will cut a simple wood circle with an engraved logo in the middle. So let's go to File and import our logo file. Lightburn supports a very wide range of file formats, from vector files to pixel images, so you can use whatever you have. Once imported, you can easily move and modify your design using the various tools and handles. Here my logo is already as I want it, but let's set its size to 50x50mm. Lightburn also includes tools to draw shapes directly in the software. We can select the ellipse tool and draw a random shape on the design. Then set it to 60x60mm to get a perfect circle. Select both items and use the align button to make sure the logo is right in the middle of the circle. When you are happy with your design, you can set its position compared to the origin point of the machine, which is set on bottom left on our machines. To do that, you can use the docking buttons here to dock your design to left and bottom, or you can enter X and Y values manually. For example, let's set the bottom left point of the design to be 10 millimeters away from the origin point. Now we want to tell the laser what he has to do with this design. In Lightburn, operations are grouped by color layers. They allow you to assign specific laser parameters to different parts of your design. You can use any of them and even save default parameters for each color if you plan to reuse the same settings often. In our case, we have two operations to do. First is engraving and second is cutting. So we will need two layers. I will select the circle and set it to the red layer and then set the logo to the blue layer. This window on the right lists all the layers of your design and their settings. We can see we now have two layers in the list. You can reorganize them and the machine will execute them starting from top to bottom. So we want to start by engraving the blue layer. You can select the laser mode for each layer and change their parameters in the fields below. Make sure the output buttons are turned on, as a layer with its output off will be visible in the design but won't be sent to the machine. For the blue layer, we want it to be engraved, which is the fill mode. Fill means the laser will scan back and forth all over the design and fill in the shapes. I set the speed to 5000 mm per minute and the maximum power to 80%. I let the pass count to 1 and the interval to 0.1. For the red layer now, I can select it and we want it to cut through the wood, so I will choose the line option, which means the laser will follow the line of the design selected. Cutting requires lower speed and more power, so I set it to 600 mm per minute and 90% maximum power, and ask for 4 passes, so the machine will run 4 times the exact same pass to be able to cut through the material. Those are parameters I tested for the 3mm MDF I will use, but they differ a lot depending on material and lasers. So refer to your laser supplier to get parameters suitable for you, or do some testings on your material. For Mekanika's machine, you can find the link to our supplier's data in the description. Be careful with the units of the values you find online. Is it millimeter per second or millimeter per minute? Do the conversion if needed. A side note, by double-clicking on a layer, you access more detailed parameters, but we won't use them in this basic tutorial. But feel free to check online for more info about it. Everything is now ready to send to the laser machine. If your laser is connected to your computer, you can control it directly in Lightburn. But in our case, we can click on Save G-code to put it on a USB key and transfer it to the CNC machine. To help the laser cut through, I put my panel on spacers so it has air to evacuate heat and smoke underneath. On Mekanika machines, you can open the G-code as per usual using the dedicated key. Press the Tool Select Change button to tell your machine that you are using the laser head and not the spindle. Now set the XY origin point and then the laser Z height using the focal length measured button and the probe. Make sure to do it on top of the material you want to engrave. Power up the adapter with the key. Then turn on the laser. You should hear the fan starting up. Now put on your mandatory protective glasses and launch the program. Always stay around your machine when the laser is on. And remember, the emergency stop will stop everything if you notice something is going wrong. Well done, you've done your first laser work. I hope you enjoyed the video and the tutorial, and you can share with us your results and your questions, of course. Until next time for the next tutorial.